Hey everyone, what's up and welcome back, it's Zach. In today's video, I'm gonna be talking about self-tanners and giving you guys a review of this self-tanner here that I actually won on an Instagram giveaway. I applied for the giveaway because my friend was running it, who is also a micro-influencer like myself, and it looks good to have a lot of engagement on a giveaway or on your Instagram feed or social media platforms in general if you want to become more of an influencer. So I figured I'll be a good friend, I'll do the credentials, and join the giveaway. So I applied for the giveaway, and then I ended up winning a self-tanner. I'll check it out, I'll test it out, and I'll let you guys know all about it. So that's what we're gonna do in this video. Before we jump into it, head over to my Instagram. Make sure that you follow that, as I did a giveaway a couple of weeks ago, and you don't want to miss out on future giveaways that will be coming up. Also, if you're not subscribed to my channel, please hit that subscribe button, as it really helps me out so that I can continue with my channel. And without further ado, let's jump into it. I honestly have no idea about this self-tanner. I've just read the box briefly. So let me look it up on my phone so I can give you guys some more information. All right, you guys, I've got some information pulled up on my phone about it. So this is the product. It is by the brand Beauty by Earth. It is their self-tanner. It says that it is safe and effective. It is a sunless tanner with natural ingredients. I do recommend using selfless tanners if you guys want to get tan. You guys know I do reviews of a lot of different sunscreens. Wearing sunscreen is very important to having great skin and preventing skin cancer, which can be deadly. But sometimes we still want to have a little bit of a tanned kind of glow, bronzy look, and I get that. Especially in the winter for me, I'm like, yo, I'm just super pale. I'm not about it. I'm down to check out a self-tanner for you guys. It also did come with this little mitt, so I will give you guys the full cost, show you what it's like on me, and let you know if you should buy it. So I'm up on the website here. It says that if you want a sun-kissed glow but don't want to spend hours baking in the sun, this natural self-tanner is the solution. You'll get healthy, beautiful, healthy tan without exposing your skin to harsh UV rays or the potentially dangerous chemicals used in conventional self-tanners. Okay, I already hate that. No. The self-tanning ingredient in all self-tanners is dihydroxytone. Self-tanners are not dangerous at all. They've been used for years. They are totally not dangerous. So I hate that they're trying to sell this like clean beauty, we're better than this. This retails for $30.99, which is a steep price point unless this is a good product. Okay, so this was a bundle that they sent me. This is worth $44.99, and it comes with this self-tanner exfoliation and application kit. So this is how you're going to put on the self-tanner, and I'm assuming the exfoliation is before. This is made in China, so I know that this costed them nothing. This product is cruelty-free, which I really like, and this does expire 12 months from opening. So it looks like this. You get 7.5 ounces of product. That is a pretty good amount. I like that. So it says, exfoliate the skin before you apply it. Apply the self-tanner evenly to the desired areas, applying thin layers. When applying to areas with loose skin, such as elbows and knees, use less product. Sometimes I've seen people that have like orange elbows and knees. And it says to wash your hands immediately after the application. I kind of want the color on my hands. That's where I was going to test it out. Allow self-tanner to dry for 15 minutes before applying makeup or clothing. I feel like that's kind of a long time. 15 minutes? If desired color is not reached within 6 hours, reapply the following days. To maintain your color, apply every 4 to 7 days or as needed. For best results, apply with our self-tanning mitts. Okay, I kind of like that. So you have to keep up with it 4 to 7 days. I actually was thinking that. I was thinking that I would do my self-tanning routine with this to test out for you guys every single Sunday and Thursday. In this kit, you get the exfoliating mitt, which I don't think I'm going to use because I feel like I don't really need it. But usually you'd like exfoliate in the shower with this before. But this kind of feels harsh, and like I don't think it's going to make that good of a difference. And then they have this little smaller mitt, so this is going to be nice to use in smaller areas on your body, or even like your fingers, your hands, so you can just like get into the crevices and stuff, so that's great. And then they have the regular sized mitt, which I have used these before, and it's just a big mitt, and it's great for like doing your body. This one feels really soft. I definitely would recommend washing it before you use it. Like when you get it in the mail, wash it and then use it, and continuously wash it to avoid bacteria. For the sake of this video and time, I'm not gonna wash mine. This product is like a clear cream. It smells like a shampoo. Literally, I have never seen a self-tanner that doesn't have fragrance. But this one also has like some oils in it that definitely would be irritating on my face. This has coconut oil, it has cranberry fruit extract, it's got coconut pulp extract, it's got vanilla fruit extract. It's got some nice things in it, like it does have green tea leaf extract, which is nice. You're using this for the self-tanner, but this definitely smells really good, not gonna lie. And it says I'm not gonna know my color for 6 hours, so I'll come back on here in 6 hours and show you guys my arm. So this is what it looks like when I put it out. It's super thick, it's not running at all, and it is straight up white. And I'm gonna try my best to get it in my fingers without using the smaller little mitt. But the key is to do your fingers last. So start up here, start blending everywhere else, and then go to the small key areas. So that is what it looks like so far. It has really done nothing. As you can see, the color difference is non-existent. So nothing has happened. So I'm just going to repeat the process. I'm just gonna pump some out into the mitt. And then, like I said, you wanna start up here in your main areas and just blend. I think I used way too much. Maybe I'll put some on my stomach. See if I get any color. I'm gonna do in between my fingers as best as I possibly can. Make sure to get the fingers. You also want to make sure that you get like right here, these areas that connect to the palm of your hand. Okay, so that smells really good. I cannot lie about it. I really like the smell. It smells good. So the right side of my body I did first. It's weird. It smells fruity, but then when you go close up, it smells like coconut. This side is not really sticky at all, actually. A little bit. It's barely sticky, it's not uncomfortable. My hands don't feel sticky at all. The side that I just did still feels sticky. So I think it's gonna take about like 4 to 5 minutes to dry down and not be sticky, though it does say don't wear any clothes for 15 minutes. But I think that's a long time, so I hope that that's not the case. I put some on my stomach and I just put my shirt back down right over it just to see what happens to show you guys, because I know that we don't all have 15 minutes. Like, think about it. It's gonna take you 5 to 10 minutes to apply, then you gotta wait for 15 minutes. I mean, what is this, a half an hour procedure? I've used other self-tanners that you can put clothes on like a minute or two later. So I will let you guys know. I will come back with how my arms are looking and we will see if there's a difference. All right, so it's the next day because it says it takes up to 6 hours, but I didn't notice literally any color at all. So I waited till the next day, I have showered and I've washed my hands once besides that, and it's kind of come off my hands, but to be honest, that is to be expected with any self-tanner, and especially right now with washing the hands so frequently, you know, it's just, it's apt to happen. You can tell a little bit here, there's like some extra buildup, which, you know, can happen, but I do think it looks pretty natural. On the arms, I do see a little bit, especially when I compare it to like my shoulder. And then for my stomach, I just put like the little bit here. You can see the tan line. So there is definitely a color difference for sure. And it does look pretty natural. It feels pretty nice. I can still smell the self-tanner a little bit. The actual fragrance like dissipated, but I can still smell the actual self-tanning ingredient. How do I look? Do I look tan? All right, guys, it has been 2 days of wearing this. Welcome to day two. After 2 days of having this on, I will tell you guys that I do not think that this is worth the price. And I don't even think it's a good product because when you put on the lotion, the self-tanner, it is white cream. So you cannot see what you're applying and how much you are. And personally, based on what you guys saw, I feel like I used a lot and I barely have a result. There is a result, but barely. That's not that great. This also says that it's supposed to last 4 to 7 days. My hands, it's still there on day 2, but it is coming off. My arms, it's not that bad, but I don't think it's going to last the 4 to 7. I think it's more 2 to 4 days, 4 being the maximum. I really like the color though. It's not orangey, it's not too brown. It does look really nice on the skin. The scent of the dioxazone smell is still there, which probably not much you can do about that, but I don't really notice that with other self-tanners that I've used. I currently use sometimes the Jergens self-tanner from the drugstore. That's like $13, $14. That's a pretty good option, and I think a much better alternative to this one here. Let me know down in the below. What? Why can't I speak English right now? Let me know in the comments down below if you use self-tanners and if this was helpful for you. As always, I will see you guys in my next video. I post videos on Mondays and Fridays, so make sure that you're subscribed and I will see you then. Take care. We'll be right back.